engineering is typically considered by many to be a non-creative, I guess, school. Much of engineering is creativity. Writing code, building hardware, any of those things. It's all about identifying which problems need to be solved, which problems are more important and less important, and coming up with a solution to it. Oftentimes, the solution that you come up with hasn't been done before, and that's not to say that it's necessarily the next groundbreaking thing, but it's something that you did, that you came up with the process to do, and it's something that has not been done in that way before, and I think that's the essence of creativity. So every year in the marching band, in the marching Illini, we have kind of a race between the engineers and the music education majors to see who has the most representation in the band. So this year we decided to go all out and design a self-playing clarinet.
Have any high aspirations for this. We don't want it to replace band members or anything by any means. Just more so for this lab, it's more so we just want to find something we were passionate about, which is music. We all have that in common.
And our desk happens to be right below this, which is a self-playing guitar, which someone who had took this course in a previous semester had built. So we're kind of not necessarily building on the work that they did, but taking inspiration from that.
It's gonna look nicer.
Hopefully, look nicer. We don't know yet. Okay, enjoyable is a strong word for it, but I'd say the first time that it made a sound was interesting and maybe painful.
It's a huge thing we had to overcome, and we're still working on, is getting the right air pressure and force on the reed inside of there. So just overcoming that and being able to get some type of sound out was really, really exciting. Even if it sounded bad.
Yeah. We ran into some issues with manufacturing this mouthpiece chamber. For example, when we pressurize it, it kind of turns into a potato gun.
Okay, here's the...
Which is fun. That was our initial.
This came flying off every, like, 20 seconds, maybe?
That's a Tupperware with some holes cut in it with an X-Acto knife. Also, the solenoids that we got originally are not powerful enough to press some of the keys, so they press most of the keys just fine, but the keys that require more force, these just aren't big enough. So now we've had to get some beefier solenoids, and we have to power those and all that kind of stuff. So there's been some challenges, but that's, I guess, what the whole engineering process is all about.